There's a phrase in Korean that's 소확행, which stands for 소소하지만 확실한 행복. And that loosely translates to small but certain things that make you happy. And I think penpalling is exactly that. They're like letters may not be something that's like a big deal. And they're honestly just like little things, but they make you really happy and they're really comforting. And I think that's one of the biggest appeals of penpalling and writing letters is that even though they're little small things, they just bring so much happiness. I think I first started penpalling around the end of last year, and I met Kay and Ella over the internet. We didn't really know each other before we started penpalling, but they reached out and they were like, hey, like I'm looking for pen pals, wouldn't anybody be interested? And I knew penpalling was something I always wanted to try.
I met Carmela through the internet about 5 years ago. And 1 year we decided to send each other Christmas cards, and then after that we just kind of didn't stop writing letters to each other.
I have always loved writing letters. I used to write letters with my elementary school crush and just ended up keeping everything from him, from my teachers, from everyone. I have like a box of like old letters that I like to keep.
Since I didn't really know Kay and Ella before we started penpalling, our letters were the way that we primarily got to know each other. And I think part of this was really refreshing because I feel like now, a lot of the time when you talk to your friends or you meet new people, it starts online and it like continues online. So it's basically a digital process. But having that paper and that letter that comes to you, you know, for us that's like maybe once every 2 weeks or 3 weeks depending on how long the letters take, but having that organic experience and that tangible memory in front of you to get to know somebody else, I think was really special.
Carmela, she like says that she doesn't have good handwriting, but she actually has like pretty good handwriting.
I learned that she has really good handwriting. My handwriting is a different story. I like to think that we have known each other for a long time and we keep up with each other's lives regularly anyway, but I also feel like we share experiences, especially like if we're talking about spirituality or boys are the main two topics we've been like talking about. A lot of what I've expressed about boys I send through letters, and so I feel like we've learned a lot about each other's love lives through letters.
It's kind of like her thoughts on paper and then she just like hands them to me, so in a way it's kind of like a tangible part of her that she's sharing with me, which is there's not really a good substitute for having physical memories with your friends, but I guess in a way it is a small physical memory.
So I was talking to Ella about it, and I think she put it really well. She says, when you create something, you always give a part of yourself in your creation. And that's why a lot of people are afraid to try it out in the first place. I believe they know deep down that when they do start penpalling, they will be exposing a part of themselves to the world, and that can be a very scary thing. But the beauty about penpalling is that you are uniquely you, and each letter that you pour yourself in reaches another soul. Your light travels to any part of the world and falls on the eyes of those who are willing to get to know you. They don't have any preconceptions of you, so you're free to present yourself the way you want without judgment.
If you want to send the same message to, say, three people, you have to write that same message three times, and you kind of go through the motions of it, and I guess it makes it that much more unique and personal that you can't really replicate through anything else.
I asked Kay the same questions and she replied by saying, I think the appeal of penpalling is making friends from far away. Every time I receive a letter and write back, it's like catching up with a friend from a long time ago. And because of the wait between receiving and sending letters, there's always so much to catch up on. I also like the comfort of being able to talk freely rather than face-to-face talks where sometimes I may feel judged and limited.
Penpalling is a lost art. Nobody really does it anymore. I wish people would take it more seriously or realize that there's so much emotion behind it and like how good it feels when you receive a letter or when you send a letter. It makes like everything you write about so much more amplified. It's so cute and pure, and I wish more people did it because it's just like a happy thing.
Ella said, I pen pal because there's nothing more fulfilling than learning about another person's story. No matter how different our backgrounds may be, wherever in the world we may be, we are able to connect like this. What I've learned is that our experiences are not global, and only through learning about others do we realize that and learn to empathize. The world is not the kindest place, but it's not as sinister either. And if we give ourselves the chance to learn from others, we'll realize that it may not be so bad after all.